Hey everyone, it's Just the Tip Tuesday, and so we're going to talk about an incredibly important subject today, a subject that I'm very passionate about, and that's going to directly affect your real estate business, and that's how to not get screwed by a private money lender. Now, what I did is I wrote down some notes right here on my little note sheet to figure out and to really communicate to you mistakes that I've seen people make that we've actually gone over and we've covered. But when you're inundated with tons of information from the bus tours and the information that we're giving you with the system, sometimes one or two things happen. Either people forget, but really the second thing is much more likely to happen. And that's where we've heard the old expression that we know what to do, but we don't do what we know. And I can't tell you how many times people go, gosh, I knew that, I just haven't been doing it. So I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna reiterate some things that's gonna be absolutely critical to not get screwed by a private money lender. Number one, don't let your private money lender ask for upfront money. Don't let them ask for down payment money or upfront money to be able to do business. They're loaning money to you. You're giving them a property for a rate of return from anywhere to 10, 12, 14% interest rate. Now, typically it's gonna be 12% interest rate. Where else is somebody gonna get 12% interest on their money? They're not gonna be getting that in the stock market. They're not gonna be going and getting that on their mutual funds. And they're definitely not gonna get that in their certificate of death, also known as a CD. So 12% rate of return. These private money lenders, they need you and they definitely need your business just like you need them and their business and their money to work. However, if they're asking you for money up front, so many times people want to give them money up front. And why is this? That comes from what I call a scarcity mentality, the feeling that there's not going to be enough, the feeling that they're going to think that if you don't go and give these individuals money up front, that they're not going to do business with you. So you get scared. So when you become scared is when people make a mistake. So I'm gonna go through this logically with you. I'm gonna teach you this in a very logical fashion about how to look and how to vet these private money lenders. But remember, the scarcity mentality, getting scared thinking, well, if I don't give them money up front, they're not gonna do business with me. I can tell you right now that's complete horse crap, because most of them, the good ones, the real ones, and the ones who really have their money on the line are gonna wanna do business with you and are not gonna ask for a lot of money up front. Now, to every rule, there's an exception. So what is the exception to this rule right here? Well, the exception to this rule is they might ask for a credit check up front, or they might go and they might ask for an appraisal up front. So let's go through these, and I'm marking these off. I got a little list, I got a little handy little checklist right here that I'm going through these things. So the credit application, if they ask you for a credit application up front, that's totally fine. Now, your normal credit app is gonna cost anywhere from 30 to 50 bucks up front. Them, it's only gonna cost them 10 to 14 bucks to run it. They make a little bit of money off of it, but who cares? Don't go tripping over dollars to pick up penny. Don't worry about that couple extra bucks they're gonna make, because they have a business to run and it takes some time and effort to go and run this paperwork. So the credit application will typically run you anywhere from 35 to 50 bucks. They're gonna go and they're gonna check your credit, and when they check your credit here, they're gonna see if they wanna do business with you. Now, normally, some people will say, well, I have bad credit. A good private investor or good private lender, that's not what they're gonna know so much look at. What they're gonna look at is see if you're in bankruptcy currently, because if so, they can't loan you money if they have any kind of brains to them whatsoever, or if you're bankruptcy, if you have been in bankruptcy that has been discharged at least 2 years or longer. So they want, if you're a private money lender, you want that bankruptcy discharged at least 2 years ago to know that that person has built up their credit or built up their sense of responsibility and their actions. So, but remember, the house is the leverage, the house is your leverage point. But if they're in bankruptcy, it has to be discharged from bankruptcy if you're the private money lender. Now, they might ask you for an appraisal, saying, well, if I have an appraisal, is that okay? Yes, you can pay for an appraisal, but the appraisal fee is about 350 bucks typically. But why do you have to pay for an appraisal when you're first just going and searching for the hard money lender and seeing if you want to deal with somebody? Now, you shouldn't have to go and pay for that appraisal until you actually have a house. So you might have a relationship with a hard money lender. You may have paid a credit check with a hard money lender. By the way, 90 to 95% of all your hard money lenders are never going to ask for a credit check up front or a credit check at all. And when you have the house, most of them, 50% of them or greater, are not going to ask for an appraisal fee because they're not going to order an appraisal. But if they do, you as the borrower, that's typically going to be your fee, it's going to be 350 bucks, but you shouldn't have to pay that until that house is under contract, that you know you have it with the bank, and during that 7-day inspection time period is when you want to order that appraisal to make sure that's going to meet your ARV values if you feel like you really need it. But more importantly, if the private money lender wants it. But if you know how to run the comps the right way, you as the borrower should need to order an appraisal, because you should be able to look at your comps in a methodical manner and know that this is going to comp out for the ARV that you've estimated. So what else is going to be, this is my sea urchin, I'm just checking stuff off. I really don't have very much sea urchin, but I'm checking shit off because it makes me feel like I'm really doing a good job here. All right, so here's another thing that's going to save you a lot of money. Look for absurd fees that they may be charging. I like calling it fees on top of fees. I hate when somebody is charging me fees on top of fees. Now, let me be very clear about this. I don't have a problem paying a broker's fee or a mortgage lender's fees, but when I start paying fees on top of fees for money that is not even that person's money, I start having an issue with it. So I might be okay paying that fee on top of a fee for the first time I do have a business relationship with this individual, but if the person's claiming to be a private money lender, but it's not their money, then they're simply being a broker. But if they haven't clearly gone and disclosed this to you, then one, they're probably not licensed, and two, you don't need them in order to be able to get the private money. So what do you do? Well, just go look at the settlement statement paperwork. The settlement statement paperwork, also known as your HUD one, when you buy the house, it'll have the line item of who the private money lender is, and it'll have the line item of the broker's fee, and you know how much you're paying for that actual broker's fee. Well, can you go and Google who the private money lender is, get their address, fill an application with that private money lender, and maybe save yourself anywhere from hundreds to more than likely thousands of dollars by cutting out the middleman who's not a true broker. Again, I don't have a problem paying a broker's fee, but they're not licensed. Why would I want to do that? And if they're not bringing true value, why would I want to do that? And you can save yourself thousands of dollars in fees off of a single real estate deal, which is nothing but beauty for you as the borrower. There's so much more to teach you with private lending, but if you want to know more, just go and leave me a comment right here, bam, right at the bottom of the blog. Leave a little comment right there for me. I'll get on there. A lot of times it's myself, sometimes it's my team. We're answering you on these blog posts on Just a Tip Tuesday. So leave us a comment about private money. I got a lot to teach you. I mean, so much to teach you about private money, so many nuances, how to get so much more private money, how to save so much more money, and how to get it way cheaper than ever before. So just leave me a little tip at the bottom. One last tip for you, because I just love doing this stuff. You want to build a relationship with a hard money lender. After the second loan they give you, ask for a reduction in interest rates. The answer may be no, but if you don't ask, the answer is always going to be no. But if they go and they drop it from 12% down to 10%, you're saving yourself thousands of dollars. Build an even stronger relationship, because they're not going to get that kind of ROI or return on investment anywhere else. So asking for a reduction in interest rate actually helps build the relationship, because they know you're serious and that you might go somewhere else, and you know that they're serious. So leave me a comment right at the bottom of the blog right there, so me and my team can get back with you. Like I said, I answer many of these questions myself. My team answers some of them. Leave us one right there. We'll get back with you guys very, very soon. And make sure that you have an amazing day. Take care. Bye.